Alright, there's one last thing that I'll try to do.
Alright, no!
No. Priest, it's okay, it works. Up. It works, I'm saying it works.
It works enough.
Alright, should we spam
anybody
this link?
Anybody here like masks?
No.
Hold on, just one thing. I'm just making sure that the people who are in the chat can hear us. Just one quick check, and then I think we're as good as we can possibly be at this point.
To the people in the chat that I said booty 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 rocking everywhere.
Something like that, yes. Exactly that, actually.
Alright. This is gonna work.
I want to lower our volume a little bit, because we're, like, getting really bad gain at the end of
it. We do sound pretty loud, but that would be the only thing I recommend.
Alright, I reduced you guys. How's that?
Perfect.
I gotta wait for
it. Well, yeah, wait for it to actually change before.
I can hear us. It works. They can hear us. I'll just have to not scream at this one very much.
Alright, we're good.
I'll try really hard not to scream, I promise.
Alright, let's do this, baby!
Alright, as everyone here who needs to be here, let's just do a quick check of that.
Yeah. I'm not here.
Present.
And we got two people.
Okay, I'm all set. Do you guys, since at this point, just... I think all of us are frustrated and I'm too feverish and drunk to care, do you want me to introduce our guests?
Yes.
Yes.
Sure.
Alright. Hi, people. Welcome to, like, whoever many of you are here. Hi, anyway. Welcome to the Good HIE podcast. We are a small group today, it looks like. That's okay, because we're also great.
I'm curious how many of us are us viewing.
Oh, fine. We have our usual crowd of Milk, me, Non-Pencil, Flaming Warfare,
Yo.
Ravage, Courier of Heartbreak.
The cool guy.
And Flutter Priest.
Hi.
We also have... our two guests. We have What Must I Do, who is probably best known for writing the longest, oh my god, what the hell am I reading thing for a period of time anyway, on fanfiction. Say hi.
Yo, dog, what up?
Exactly. And we have my child, Bolding, who is wonderful, and I love him very much, and he hates me sometimes, but that's okay, because I will always love him.
He's explosive with black.
Did I hear a hello at least?
I said, oh shit, what up?
Oh shit, what up? Okay, that worked.
Someone using Pastebin.
Okay, so we're going to ask some questions. If you want to ask them any extra questions, please feel free to do so in the chat. We will ask them no matter what it is. There's no question too stupid because there's no way any of us are, you know.
And
so anything better to be doing.
Following along in the stream can see the list of questions on the bottom of the Twitch chat.
What are you using to show that?
Fucking
Facebook. Oh god. Also, I'm just going to say, just to start things off, What Must I Do? My friend was absolutely obsessed with diaries for so long, it was all he'd talk about.
Cool. Is your friend
hot? Okay.
Cool. All right.
Is she hot?
I'm gonna guess no. All right. We have some really great questions. Is this question stupid? No question too stupid. We have some really great questions to start off with. I'm gonna try to do what Priest did last time because he did a good job of that, which is I'm going to ask the guests. I'm just gonna probably alternate whatever. Which one of you wants to start first? Our guests will answer the questions first. If we want to answer because it's awesome, we will answer as well. To start with, Bolding. Should you find a pony in your backyard, what is the logical reason not to skullfuck it? Fair. What Must I Do? Same question.
What if it's best pony? I wouldn't want to kill it.
You can skullfuck ponies without killing them. It's possible.
Oh, that's right. I forgot nasal spray.
Yeah.
In that case, Christ. I guess there isn't a good reason not to.
Thank you. I agree. Alright, this is all from Cherished, by the way.
I knew it!
No one should be surprised that this is the Cherished questions. next! Oh, this is for both of you, but we'll start with What Must I Do. What Must I Do? Why is Bolding so perfect?
Those beautiful eyes of his.
Oh, babies.
He's explosively black.
Like, calm down.
Because he's the demo man.
Exploding out of his clothes, maybe.
Oh, baby. Bolding, why are you so perfect?
Quite the on the contrary, I'm going to explain reasons why I'm not.
You know what I say.
I'm not. And I'm not.
Could I answer this question?
Brought you by alcohol.
Could I answer this question?
Sure, go for it.
Because there's no other human being on Earth who can drink and tell stories like this man, and I'm not even kidding. Give this man alcohol, and the stories that will come from his mouth are some of the most grotesque, horrifying, and wonderful stories that you'll ever hear. They will involve feces and sex. They will involve horrible childhood memories and wonderful childhood memories. And it just will not end, and you can sit up all night sitting like a child, just sipping whatever alcohol you have, listening to him go on and on. It's wonderful. That's what makes him perfect.
Sonic fursuits.
Sure, yeah. Someone asks a question like that about him, and you answer right away, but you still haven't answered my question.
I will never answer your question. Never. Never.
You're a dick.
I am a dick. Okay. Building. How bad do brony conventions smell?
Yes. You ever been in a hotel before?
Well, yes, I have.
That's what it smells like. That's
yeah, like. I would back him up on this. It just smells like a hotel. What must I do? Same question for obvious reasons.
I went to BronyCon, and it was right on the fucking Baltimore Harbor. It was absolutely awful the entire time.
Did it smell like ocean?
Like bad like ocean? Ocean, like bad ocean mixed with bad body odor.
Huh.
Good God.
Sounds magical?
There was not very much friendship involved.
Smell like Navarone. And mixed with a little bit of sheep.
Okay. All right. I have a question that is very simple, and I think it's a very serious question. What must I do? Does Scootaloo actually deserve to be adopted?
Contrary to popular belief, one man's trash is not another man's treasure.
Oh, fuck.
You fucking take that back.
Why is she not already in my chicken nuggets?
Because that joke is overrated and fucking dead.
I was going to say you're overrated, but that's not true. Holding, what is your opinion on whether or not Scootaloo deserves to be adopted in the first place?
I would take her home and put her in a nice warm bed, feed her a decent meal, and then proceed to skull fuck her.
All right.
You'd put her in the bed and then feed her a meal?
That seems like it's building up a little bit.
But
too
she
much.
Gets like never had a crumbs meal. In the bed.
I don't care.
Is it a meal of your dick?
Yeah, it makes the order up.
Yeah, the meal should be your dick. It's that simple. Yeah. Does anyone else want to weigh in on this?
Milk? No. You wanna?
Yeah, Milk, you wanna say something?
I ain't wanting on this one.
I think you do.
All right. Well, I know what Milk's gonna say. Milk's actual feelings is that Scootaloo never deserves to be adopted because she's unworthy of love. Correct?
Oh wow! No, fuck you.
She's not even alive. She's like a cardboard cutout that they just put googly eyes on.
She just doesn't exist.
She's a figment of his
imagination. Like a Loch Ness monster.
Okay. How far can a seagull stretch its neck? Bolding.
If I'm not mistaken, it was 10 inches.
That's enough.
Really distressing the way you put that, actually. there's so much implication there.
From experience, not far enough to fit my dick down there.
Oh.
Is there one on top of your island pie?
I don't know. You have to tell me. I can't see the picture.
It's a dick island.
It's an island pie.
It'll stretch as far as I want it to stretch.
it'll blow up like that frog from Shrek.
Oh, good. I actually just wrote about... I wrote about weird alcohol for my job, and one of the things was an Eskimo alcohol, which is where you take a seagull and you put it in a bottle, just a dead seagull, you put it in a bottle and you put it in the sun and you let it ferment, and that's how you get booze up in Eskimo land.
Makes sense.
Yep, they take a seagull and ferment it in the sun and then they drink it. That is, I'm not lying, that's an actual thing.
Hot.
So, there you go, things that you now know. Here's a question. Should there be another Equestria Girls?
No.
No.
Hell no.
There shouldn't
so
have
that
been
a resounding
one.
No?
There needs to be an expansion on the Apocalypse story.
Yeah. I think so, too.
So hell no.
Hell no. Alright, so a resounding hell no. I think that's really fair.
Mm-hmm.
we have another question from Seven. who is going to their first con later this month and will be hosting a panel with a friend. What can you expect at a con? Boulding, what can he expect at a con? Boulding.
Boulding.
I think Boulding's dead. Anyway.
Oh, there we go, there we go. Sorry, it muted. I am so sorry.
Drunk.
What should they expect?
That's what
just apologies.
No, but in all seriousness, if you're going with friends, you should have a good time. As long as you bring, I don't know if you're into drinking alcohol or not, or doing drugs or whatever the fuck you do.
They're in this fandom. They're into something. I'm sure.
Maybe memes. Whatever. There's a lot of memes. Know that quality
memes.
And dabbing. Just that's all you
quality
need.
Quality memes. Comedy. Quality dabbing.
And dabbing. Essentially, just it's gonna be fun. Just make sure you have fun. Don't try to beat around the bush and bullshit and try to act all cool.
Don't punch any cosplayers if they try showing you the Lion King.
Do not
punch any cops in the dick, okay?
Yes. Ever. For love of God, do not punch a cop in the dick and run from hotel security because you wall kicked off the fucking wall and ended up puncturing a hole.
Holding, it's okay. He won't hurt us anymore. It's okay. He'll never hurt us again.
What happened at that con?
Okay.
I don't know if that's a story we want to tell on the podcast.
No.
You ever see Lord of the Rings with that evil
eye? I never want to tell that story again. What must I do? Same question. I think Priest wants to weigh in after that.
I like that.
What to expect at a con?
Yeah. Hosting a panel.
I've never hosted a panel, but at the con, there was mostly normal people with a lot of outliers, a lot of unnormal people, and a lot more kids than I was expecting. So just go with friends and try not to get separated or you might get raped.
I think that's fair.
By the kids?
Yeah. Yes. You don't even know. They will.
They'll rape you with tears.
Those kids will drag you into the closet.
So, Priest.
You
were
going to
say something.
You already mentioned you're going with friends to the convention, which is a really, really good thing. The best way to go to a convention is easily to enjoy it with friends, because it's going to be valuable memories. Like, I know I fucking loved every single day that I fucking spent at BabsCon with Boulding and Pencil. It was great. But when it comes to panels, that's something I can help with a little bit. When you run your panel, it's probably best to focus on playing it kind of fast and loose. Like, have an idea of what you want to touch on, and like try and make sure you have a lot of content to talk about. Whoops. But at the same time, your panel is not going to go the way you expect at all. Like, at all. You might have someone randomly decide to be like, hey, I'm gonna have fun and join with you, or you'll have hecklers in the audience, or nobody will show up, like, or you'll have a packed house and then be extremely nervous. There's all sorts of things that could happen, and just plan for nothing, expect everything, and have a good time. That's the rule.
I think that's actually super fair. Yeah, I would agree. Being on some of the panels, it's really fun, but you have to be able to roll with the punches. You really do.
Or you might have someone with a Sunset Dakimakura next to you.
No,
that's really distracting.
That was distracting. Player. Thanks.
With veins on it.
I'm sitting next to him wearing a pretty dress, and he's like, Dakimakura, and everybody in the group is like, Dakimakura, except for Boulding, who's looking at me like, why am I here? Please get me out of here.
How did I? Oh yeah, it was amazing.
He has that moment of sobriety.
Wait.
Do you want me to take over, Pencil? I'm less pissy now.
No, it's okay. I'm doing fine. I'm going to ask the next question because I answered it for him, and I would like to see what Boulding's answer is. Okay. Question for what must I do? How much acid should I take before this call? My answer was so much.
Yes.
Yes.
Boulding's answer is yes. I think that is quite fair.
Unfortunately, my roommate with the acid took it all to Chattanooga to try and sell it, so I didn't get to do any.
You poor baby. I'm sorry.
It's awful.
Sucks.
I'm sober right now.
All right. Now we get on to some... Now we're going to circle jerk a little bit, guys. Here we go. This is literally... What we're about to do is the definition of circle jerk. And I'm just gonna
wait,
tell you
we weren't already?
No, now it's going to get circle jerky. What is the definition of a circle jerk? And who do you think are the groups most guilty of it? First of all, before anyone else answers, I'm going to say this one. We're pretty bad. Boulding, would you like to weigh in?
A circle jerk is basically a group that feels that they are superior to everyone and that they are in a secret club that allows no one in because they are not cool enough unless another member of the group brings in someone that they feel is great enough and will do so. Or
literally something. This. Literally this.
I essentially think the worst ones will be Horse News, Equestria Daily.
Yeah.
Derpy yeah, Hooves, okay. Mail or whatever the fuck it was, and the whole of / MLP.
Yeah, no, that's yeah, okay. What must I do? Would you like to add anything to that?
I definitely agree with his definition, but I have to add the Conversion Bureau people, like everyone in that fucking fandom.
Oh, jeez. Yeah.
And AIE in general.
Yeah, AIE is really circle jerky.
Can we just get, like, groups from all the really popular stories and just to go to war with each other?
Fallout Equestria. Fallout Equestria. I totally
Fallout
forgot that.
Fallout Equestria versus Bastions. Who survives?
Oh, God.
Oh, God.
You're human.
So the next question, start with what must I do. What is quality?
All right, I'm not sure about that one. I know it's a reference, but I don't get that one.
No, just what is quality? That's
USA
all you
made.
Good things, I guess.
There's no need to answer any of the questions from now on, seriously. I'm just going to tell you right now, at this point, I think 90% of the questions are shitposting, so shitpost back.
It's
have
cherished.
Fun. It's not right. Cherished. This is Rav.
Rav,
yeah.
You suck.
All right, Bolden.
Come on, Bolden, at the same time.
Bolden
one,
ball.
Two, three, quality.
Fuck you guys.
Anyway,
I'd buy that for a dollar.
Quality is when everything goes just right. And I'm doing I'm doing the hand motion right now.
You can't and see. I was too, so I'm just as guilty.
Rav, I already told you suck, so I'm good.
Oh my god, you guys. Alright, this is an important question. It's specifically for Bolding. Hey, Bolding! How many midgets did you fight at BabsCon?
Alright.
Tell the story, my friend.
So, while we were at the con, I was sleeping in a bed with Liger, and I was laying
Liger Storm is my sweet little Asian Shota who I love very much. Go on.
And throughout the night, I kept beating the shit out of him in his sleep.
By the way, he said the only way he could make you stop was to throw a leg, like, across your dick, because then you'd move away uncomfortably, and that was the only way he could get you to stop.
Essentially, I had a dream that I was fighting a midget. And I was beating the shit out of Liger while in the middle of that dream. So,
but because the thing is, he wakes up and Liger looks at me. He's like, "I didn't sleep." Bolding kept punching me and kicking me, and I just like had to like try to make him stop by putting my leg over his dick, and he wouldn't stop. Bolding comes out of the bathroom and looks and goes, "Dude, I had a dream last night. I was fighting a midget. Like, you just punched Liger in your sleep. That's all you did." Just to be clear, Liger's like 5'3", so.
And he's I'm 6'3".
So. Yeah, so he's just beating up Liger in his dream, thinking he was fighting midgets. So how many midgets was it, Bolden?
One.
Just one?
No, just one. And he was whooping my ass, but
that's because
he had the advantage. He had better surface area grab.
He was hopping around like Yoda.
I will tell Liger
that. 7814493 has another question, but I'm going to add it to the end of the list of questions.
Fair enough, but we'll answer that with the end 7. Okay, next question. How many... No, not that's... I already asked that.
Should
a chainsaw sound like a person snoring or the other way around?
Oh, God. Jesus Christ.
what must I do?
So, can I take the liberty on this?
You may, but I want to know what must I do's answer just for funsies.
A chainsaw should sound like a person since people came first.
There you go. Thank you. All right.
So... Rav, you put this question in, didn't you?
Yeah.
So this is another kind of callback to when we were all hanging out at BabsCon, and we kind of all shared a room. And when we were getting ready to go, we all turned to kind of like Rav and Venates and everyone who kind of chilled with us, and we looked at it, we told them, it's like, well, we have to kind of warn you. Bolding snores like an angel being stabbed to death. It's fucking terrifying. And everyone's like, oh yeah, no, it's not
fine,
that big
it's
deal.
Fine.
But then it started happening. And Rav, would you please then continue and tell me what it was like? Please comment on the experience.
Alright, so what happened was I fell asleep like an hour, maybe 30 minutes before everybody else did, right? And so I wake up about 3 a.m. I have to find my way around the room because I've got people laying on the floor and I hear bolding. And I swear, I have never heard anybody snore like this.
My favorite was when he started snoring like Quagmire. In the middle of the night, he started like he was.
Wait, hold up, what?
Good. Like, is he giggity in his sleep?
That's not Quagmire, that's Popeye.
No, because he did it more, and he sounded more and more like giggity every time. And I was like, is he just saying giggity giggity in his sleep? Because if he is, I don't want to know what he's dreaming about.
Was this during the guy touching him with his foot?
No, it was the next night.
Okay.
No, and there was another point. I think I might have been the only one still awake because I have trouble falling asleep. And
I'm so sorry. I kicked you so
I
much.
I swear to God, Bolding was getting ready to fucking do a disturb thing because he was like, and I was like, oh God, is he okay?
Guys, can you see the stream right now? Because right now it's loading on Twitch and I can't see anything.
I see it. Yeah,
it's buffering. You're good.
It's been buffering for 5 minutes. I'm just gonna...
It is playing. Don't worry. So let's go on to the next question.
All right.
How many cadence? Oh, this is so circle jerky, Raph. What did you do? How many cadences have died in Minecraft? Somewhere there is probably someone.
It's five.
There's probably someone who hates her as much as I do somewhere who has just killed her repeatedly in Minecraft. I would believe.
Have you not told her about the Minecraft escapades?
Oh no, he told me.
Okay.
I lost a lot of respect for all of you.
There was respect.
Add any?
Why do you respect these people?
Next.
What do you mean, these people?
That's racist.
Yeah,
people in here and also niggers.
Wow.
There goes this Twitch channel.
There goes Flutter Priest Twitch right
there. Hey, Priest, use your camera, flash it.
Actually, what must I do? Here's an actual question. How many people do you think you've freaked out in your lifetime?
In high school, in middle school, in elementary school, I was that kid, so a lot. I had teachers thinking I was good. The weird emo one that did, like, weird shit for attention, I was that one.
Did you wear a trench coat?
Oh, they thought you were going to go Columbine.
Yeah, the teachers actually straight up thought I was going to shoot up the school.
Oh my God.
My senior year, I asked one of them what would happen if I told her to stay home one day, and she's like, I would probably call the cops and not go.
Oh, you asked her that question hypothetically. What did
hypothetically,
I tell you?
If I had a friend that was gonna murder everybody.
No, just she told me freshman year that if I ever was gonna shoot the school up, tell her before to stay at home. So I asked her that question.
Would you rather be
I would
or
fuck
creepy?
With her then.
That's terrifying.
Yeah, senior year, I asked her that question, and the next day she didn't show up.
Oh, you killed her.
My God. Jesus Christ.
Did you go to her
so,
house?
So yes, I freaked out a lot of people in my lifetime.
That's special. Oh, like,
I'm surprised
Jesus.
You're out of prison.
I'm impressed. Shit. Bolding, same question.
Where do I begin? There was a fourth grade when I tried to show a bunch of girls my dick. For the rest, this is really circle jerky, but a lot of you won't understand this, but I'm not going through that story, but everyone here who was at the con will know exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Aside from that, I was the big guy for you that, essentially people, like, little fucks would try to start shit with to establish dominance, and, I used to beat the shit out of them. Because they didn't realize their size. They were like little Yorkies. And for the most part, everyone was kind of scared of me. Because I beat the shit out of people. But only if you fucked with me.
Well, you're pretty scary. What can you say?
Thanks.
Bolding, you know I think you're a giant teddy bear and I want to hug you forever. I would cuddle your cutie woody little face. Do you realize Bolding's not actually black, right?
He's explosively black.
No,
like Bolding is a large human being. He is very tall and he will punch you in your face, but only if you ask him to really nicely.
You know, I've been the one posting the picture of you penetrating him with a bottle over and over, so I think.
Oh, yeah. All right, that picture. Yeah, that's been passed around now, Bolding.
Oh, good.
Yep, that's figured like that.
That's not my brother, good.
Fuck. What is the proper way to greet a fellow con-goer we're bolding?
What's that?
What's the proper way to greet a fellow con-goer?
Memes.
Memes is correct.
Only the dankest of memes.
If you go up to someone and you dab and they don't understand you, you walk away. If you don't know what a dab is, you need to Google it.
Speak softly and carry a fat sack of dank memes.
You want to do me?
Also, if you ever see Jesus at a con, you have to dab with him.
If you scream aloud, "Oh shit, boy," and someone screams back at you, "He about to do it," you're probably good.
Gotta tickle his pickle.
For me, I run and jump tackle people, so that happens. All right.
Surprise, Rav didn't eat you.
No, Rav, I think I terrified him on a couple of occasions. So what must I do? I want actually your opinion on this, since you've been to BronyCon, which is a little bit of a different... Oh my god, I almost said different horse. A little bit more beast than... Exactly. A little bit different beast than VabsCon. How do you recommend you greet a fellow con-goer?
Awkwardly avert your gaze, hope they don't talk to you. If they do, pull spaghetti out of your pocket and throw them at them, then run.
The only proper response.
Stop. I don't want to discuss this any further.
Throw a sponge in their face.
I thought you did. Okay.
I'm pretty sure that I'm banned from BronyCon, but I don't want to test that theory.
That's fair.
They probably forgot by this point. It's been like, what?
I mean, it was.
I thought
you
were
going
to go to the upcoming BronyCon, though.
What did
you do?
If other people do, I'm going. But...
I'm not
going
to go. I can't. I just don't have the finances.
What did you do to get banned from BronyCon?
Well, then, do you want to tell the story?
I used to work for an ATM company called Diebold.
Here we fucking go. I'm ready. Go on.
I used to fix, obviously, and ATMs for a living.
Mm-hmm.
And we were required to carry sidearms on us in order to, protect ourselves in the event that someone tried to do something stupid.
Mm-hmm.
Well, in 2012, BronyCon was being held in the Sea Caucus Meadowlands Center, or Meadowlands Convention Center, which is over in New Jersey.
Mm-hmm.
This was many years before they decided to make Boston their established point. The year before, it was New York, et cetera, et cetera. Mind you, this is when I'm in the fandom, but I'm starting to get used to the people around it and everything. And I pull up at this one ATM. It's a Chase Bank across the street from it. And there's a bunch of people dressed up as Pwn. And I'm just like, the fuck is going on? What is this weirdo fest going on here? total normie. So, I fix up the ATM and I get outside, and sure enough, this guy is going to pull money, and he's dressed up as Fluttershy, about, I want to say, 370 pounds or so. And I come up
to
him.
You saw
like...
me!
So, I go up to this dude, and I'm like, yo, what's going on over here? Is there an anime con? Because I'm pretty sure that Anime Next isn't until, like, fucking July, and on top of that, it's usually held in Somerset County. And he's like, oh, it's BronyCon. And I'm like, the fuck is that? And he's like, oh, it's for My Little Pony convention. And all I could think was, oh my god, they actually did it.
Did you ask him if he was Kirby and swallowed the thing he was dressed up as?
No. That would have been fucking amazing. I need to use that next time.
Oh my god.
So, mind you, people who know me, I'm a complete asshole when we're walking, whenever I'm at a con. At least to people I don't know.
Yeah, he's wonderful about that, though, actually. It's a great way. If you ever need, like, a buffer between you and Aspies, he is the perfect person.
So, I mean, for the most part, I still love that I dressed up as Dan from Dan Versus with Pencil.
Oh.
The first time we met, we're walking down the way, and I'm holding a box of donuts for her. And someone's like, ooh, Psycho Donuts, can I get one? And I just turn to him, and I'm like, fuck off. And the kid's like, kind of like...
And that's when I fell in love with Balding. I just looked up at him. I'm in this, like, little pink lowly dress, and I'm terrified because everybody keeps on going, like, donuts, give me! And, like, running up to me, and I'm tiny. I'm just like, ah. He comes over, picks up the donut box, is walking, and this one guy just, like... Oh, some dose. He goes, hey, fuck off. And the guy just looks at him, and I just look at him like,
So I get home from work that day, and I'm sitting there, and I'm like, I can't get over this, the fact that there's a convention for My Little Pony. And it gets to this point where I'm going through /MLP, and they were having these threads during the time about people dropping spaghetti out of their pockets when they went to go to McDonald's to go buy the toys. So I'm like, oh my god, this is the perfect idea. So I go down to Walmart, I buy like 10 boxes of fucking spaghetti, like pound boxes. And I start boiling this big ass cold my mom had with spaghetti. And it gets to the point where, like, I have too much spaghetti. But that's beside the point. Anyway, I finish up, I cool it off, I put it in Ziploc bags, and the entire time my mom's like, what the fuck are you doing with so much spaghetti? And I'm like, I'm feeding the homeless, don't worry about it. So the next day I wake up in the morning and I'm like, all right, I'm going to call out, which was usually an easy procedure. I called my boss. I said, hey, I'm not coming in. He'd be like, okay, we'll find someone to cover you. Well, this time he decided, no, I'm going to ask you, why are you calling out? Now, mind you, I don't have an excuse ready for this because I never needed one. So I panic. And I'm like, I have cancer. And I hung up. He starts texting, blowing up my phone, going, what the fuck is going on? Are you okay? Everything like that. So I'm like, listen, I just day off. I'm fine. I just need a day off. And he's like, all right, do what you have.
24-hour cancer.
So...
Did you break phlegm? Is that what I'm hearing squeaking?
Oh my god! I'm gonna fucking die!
So, I drive down to the Sea Caucus Center, park in the parking lot, paid a fucking $10 fucking parking fee, and I go inside. Now, they won't let me into the con because I am wearing my fucking, I still have my sidearm on me. And
she said it was a prop.
My job requires me to hold on to it because anytime someone can try to get me to break into a fucking ATM or something like that, and I need something to defend myself because, you know, I'm dealing with federal money. So I'm talking with the con. I'm fighting with them basically to let me in. Eventually they agree, hey, let us take a photocopy or a fucking picture where this guy pulls out an iPhone, takes a picture of my fucking concealed carry license and all my permits for work and everything. Takes a picture of my ID, everything like that. So he takes the pictures. I go inside. Meanwhile, every pocket in that I have on my person is filled with bags of spaghetti. I go into the bathroom and wash my hands to get rid of the grime from this, what's about to happen. And I come outside, and immediately some big-ass motherfucker dressed up as Big Mac comes up, and he's like, yo, bro hoof me, and puts out his fist. At this point, I'm like, I just look at him dead in the eyes, deadpan stare, and I'm like, it's time. Reach into my pocket, grab this handful of spaghetti, and I go to pull it out. And I just start dropping it. At this point, I start going in a panic state, and I kneel down on the ground, and I'm trying to pick it up, and I keep letting it slip between my fingers. And I'm
we're
like,
still talking about spaghetti, right?
Yes. Yeah, I'm okay. Fake choking, like crying, like trying to withstand myself and crying, like. And like this guy is appalled. Like it looked like I fucking insulted his great dead grandmother or something. And he's just like, all right, man, see you later, and walks away. I just walk off. I do this to 10 people. 10 people I do this to. Only 2 got the reference. And they were my best friends through that con. It was just like, they're like, I get it. And I was just like, yeah, you're fucking cool.
So it probably wasn't worth it.
No.
That gets better.
It's worse. Not better. So... I decide to go over to the vendor hall, and I'm looking around, and I'm like, oh, that plushie looks fucking awesome. Like, oh, I might buy... Oh, no, that's $200. I'm not buying it. I'm just gonna look at it. So I pick it up, and I'm looking at it, and someone taps me on the fucking shoulder. I turn around, and it's not con security. It is the convention center security.
Oh, God. Shit.
And they're just like, excuse me, sir, And as soon as they said that, I'm like, I know where this is going to go. They're going to bother me about having a gun on me, yada, yada. So eventually, they're like, do you have paperwork for your firearm? I'm like, sure, just let me grab it. And I reach into my back pocket and immediately feel cold spaghetti. And at this moment, I stop and I look down to the ground, and all I can think of is, you live long enough to become the villain, or you die a legend. And I grab a handful of spaghetti. This guy puts his hand out, ready to grab it. And I just put a handful of spaghetti. The look on this guy's fucking face was priceless. I wish I could somehow write down how this face looked, but there is no way.
I need more brandy. Oh my god.
He eventually gets to the point where he realizes what's in his hand, but can't comprehend why.
Wait, how's Flamenwerfer doing? I can't hear him.
Dying.
I think he's dead.
Fam is dead.
I think he just shot himself.
No, he actually may need his asthma inhaler, guys, so continue holding.
So,
something inhaling a bunch of gas.
I look around as he's looking in his hand in utter disgust. And I book it. I just start running.
I'm actually worried about Flam right now.
I'm okay.
He'll be okay.
The crowd,
he's getting gas. Don't worry about it.
And by to this day, I believe there's a god because of this reason alone. There was a fire that started during the fucking panel for Terra Strong and everybody in one of the light fixtures. It just burst into flames. And everyone was fucking booking it out of the door. So I just blended in with the crowd and left.
So you don't know if you're banned. You just don't want to
hold on.
No, it gets so much better. It gets genuinely better.
It still gets better?
How the
hell does it get better?
No.
So I get in my car. I drive off. I get home. I clean out all the spaghetti from my pockets. I lay down in my bed and I'm like, I am such a fucking idiot. So I'm just sitting there laying, looking at the ceiling, and my phone starts going off. My work phone.
Oh, shit.
So I'm like, what the fuck is going on? And I go and look, and it's my boss, William Friend. I still love him because his last name was Friend, and I used to call him my best friend, and he used to get mad. But anyway, I'm looking at the phone, and it's him, and I'm like, I'm supposed to be off today. I called out. Fuck it, I'll answer it. So I answer it, and he's like, all he says is, you need to be in the office on Monday morning. Click. And I'm just like, oh, God, this is it. This is how it ends. So I drive all the way down to fucking East Windsor to where the station's at.
Oh, God. It's
pull in. And normally this guy is sitting at his desk, clacking away at his keyboard, and then he'll usually say, take a seat, whatever, and continue with his work. No, not this time. I come around the corner, and he's turned to me in his rotating chair with his arms crossed and a leg over his other. And he's just looking at me, pissed as shit.
Please tell me he over-rotated.
Wait.
He looks at me. He closes the cubicle with its little fucking panel that it has, and he's like, take a seat. So I sit down, and I'm like, what am I here for? And he's like, you have cancer, huh? And I'm like, no, that was a panic moment because I needed to call out. He's like, I know. Your little escapade over at fucking the Meadowlands Convention Center, they called me because you gave them all your information like a fucking idiot.
God.
Like, okay. And he was like, do you know why the fucking security was coming up to bother you? And I'm like, because I had a gun on me. And they're like, no, because you were leaving spaghetti on the fucking floor. Why the fuck was your pocket filled with spaghetti? So
it's federal spaghetti.
I'm going to explain to him the whole fucking thing about being stopped and all this. And the entire time he's just looking at me like, this kid is fucking retarded. I heard it. So eventually it's like, we got one of two options here because they're really pissed and I have to clean up that spaghetti because of you. I had to go there and see said spaghetti to ensure that I could determine how much the damages would cost.
Spaghetti fucking destroying property, right?
I think one of the cosplayers choked on it and died.
Wait.
Apparently someone stepped on it and they're like mashed. Anyway. So he pulls out a fucking Tupperware from his filing cabinet and guess what is inside of it?
Spaghetti.
Mom's spaghetti.
Spaghetti.
What? Where did the spaghetti come from?
That said floor.
Okay.
So
he picked up the spaghetti off of the floor in the convention center that Boulding dropped.
Yeah.
So he hands it off to me, and he's like, "We have two options here." Okay, I'm listening. One, I can fire you right here. You hand in all your stuff. I call you a taxi to get home. Okay, I'm listening to option two now. You eat said spaghetti in front of you, which was from your batch, if you will. And I let everyone know that you watch a show for little girls. So I just open the container and just grab a pinch full with my fingers and just start eating it. And the entire time I'm going, I fucking hate everything right now. And
was it all like hairy?
Did you eat every bite?
Not all of it. He made me take only one bite, but so that's why I fear I might be banned from BronyCon.
So you don't know.
Do you see what I mean about holding stories, by the way, guys? This is why I wanted him on these streams, because he does shit like this.
He needs to get a desk job around a campfire telling stories.
I fucking know. It's true.
Were we answering questions at one point?
Yeah, I'm going to go back to questions. That was really hard. It's hard to go back. Okay. Hey, next question's easy, because we can all say it in unison. Would you vote for Ravage to be president? Unison answer. Yes. No.
Yes. I heard a yes in there. Fuck you.
Probably Rath.
Hey, 5 years ago, if someone told me Donald Trump would be leading in the president,
you cannot compare Rav to Donald Trump. Rav has a moral compass.
That's why I'm saying yes.
We have 51 more questions.
Enough of politics. Boulding, imaginary friend, when?
Maybe.
Maybe. That's a start.
Maybe o'clock.
What must I do? Million word sequel expansion of the Royal Punisher Cuddler universe when?
That guy's a pervert, and possibly.
Oh, okay. Answers that. Okay, I'll start with Boulding again. Is Luna a better warrior than Celestia?
No.
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 What must I do? No?
She's 1,000 years out of power.
She got her ass fucking bolted to the moon. Get over it.
Oh, that's a very good point, actually.
She got sticky noted.
So, what must I do? What is your consensus on this?
I'm going to go with probably.
Probably? Ooh. Okay.
She's got that Yoda midget going on.
All right.
Celestia cheated. She used the elements.
What story portrays her the best? Boulding, what story portrays Luna the best?
None. Because Luna's a shit character.
Milk.
Fuck right off, mate.
What must
that
I
story
do?
By the guy who wrote The Chase that I downvoted because I didn't like it.
No, what must I do? Who portrays Luna the best?
I like Jastiet's portrayal.
I adore you. By the way, Boulding, not mentioning Mooney.
Alright, Mooney is one except... Oh, wait,
no, not Luna.
I make a point to mention Mooney every podcast. Now is the time. Mooney's great. Go read Mooney.
Yes,
I feel like that
one's
cheating. I feel like that one's cheating because that's not Luna. That's Nightmare Moon.
Still go read
Mooney. Same thing.
Oh, no, please do. By all means, go read
Luna
it.
Luna makes
a fucking great story.
Okay. Hold on. Luna
Shut
makes
up.
An actual
Shit.
Appearance Hold up. In Mooney. And I like the way that Luna is portrayed in the Mooney story. I'm actually sad that there isn't more Luna-based chapters of Mooney.
Ace is great. His story's great. Go read it.
Don't link.
I think I'm done asking about Luna. Regarding HIE stories. Okay. Actually, this is really interesting. What must I do? What's your favorite method for a human to find his way to Equestria? And what is the lamest?
My favorite would probably be getting there in an acid trip or something like that and not realizing that all this shit's actually real. And the lamest is probably them just like waking up in the Everfree and then getting saved by one of the ponies.
Or not getting saved.
Murder.
Either or. Waking up in the Everfree. Just
Evergreenheart, the guy got destroyed by Timberwolves.
And that's the end of the story.
No, he fucked
No, that's the beginning of the story.
He became their pack leader. I will never get over that fucking
Oh,
story.
God, that fucking story.
Oh, God.
So, same question to everybody?
I just like seeing new ones. If anything new is interesting and seemingly plausible, I'll read it.
I gotta admit, Terriers is probably the most unique one I've seen in a while.
I have to go with the traditional... my waifu's here. I have to go with the traditional, you know, he was there already. There's no need to explain why he showed up.
Yeah, I think, Bolding, I think you and I are alike on that. I think that too much time taken explaining on how Anon got there, if it's not the central point of the story, is just wasted words.
Thank you.
It's true.
It fits in with Anon, but...
Sometimes it's not even worth just telling that he's there. If it's not the central point, as you said, just he's just fucking there. Deal with it, kind of thing. Like,
all right. Well, I mean, his fucking name is Jason. Fucking just, you know. Just
I don't go on phone. I'm sorry.
Sorry.
All right.
Yeah.
Here's a really good piece of advice regarding the HIE and, you know, origin of Anon. My instructor from my creative writing class, which I'm now finally done with my finals. Yay!
Congratulations.
Thank you. And I think I aced it. So, the best piece of advice is the same thing, same advice you give to anybody writing a book. Start with the interesting scene. Don't bother with the build-up. Don't bother with the exposition. Start with the most interesting thing. If the most interesting thing is how your human character got to Equestria, then start with that. If it's not, fucking leave it out.
Yeah. For short stories, I can agree with that.
You too, thanks.
All right. Numero four, yes. If the universe is infinite in size or it branches into a multiverse, then every pattern of matter that can arise must arise. Please scroll, priest. I can't read that.
Doesn't that mean that there's something very much like Equestria out there somewhere?
The answer is no wish fulfillment. Anyway,
just because everything can possibly no, just fucking... doesn't mean everything does exist.
Yeah.
It has literally probability zero.
You guys need to watch Rick and Morty.
Yeah.
The answer is no. What kind of faggot are you? Jesus.
Is that the kind you are?
Oh, God. No. The fucking next question.
I bet you just...
Okay. Next question. I love this question. What must I do? This goes to you. Why didn't they shoot Rainbow Dash when she broke her leg? Was it to keep her around for breeding?
She doesn't race on her
legs.
That
gotta go fast, Jean.
She's got wings.
Gotta cheat.
Thank you for that. Bolding, why didn't they shoot Rainbow Dash? Was it a breeding thing?
No, because they Celestia outlawed guns, and she's taken away her Second Amendment.
What a bitch.
They need to build a wall.
We need to build a wall between Canterlot and Ponyville.
And legs.
Or Trump for president.
Oh man, only down to 44 questions, guys.
I'm working on it, okay? Bitch.
She doesn't use her legs all that often.
Alright, are we on to my questions? Here we fucking go.
No!
It's time.
Holding. Christ.
What is the most disgusting thing you've ever done?
Why did you do this? You really want people to hear this story, don't you?
Yes. I do!
We're going to be here for 8 hours listening to
this. It doesn't matter! I'll go through the rest of
the three-point
really
story.
Alright, let's rewind here. Just back to Bolding, 16 years old.
This is the best.
Sophomore year, going during the summer to lunch with the friends. The friends are like, "Hey, Bolding, let's go get something to eat. Let's go get some pizza. If we put $5 in a piece, we can get two pies, and we can, you know, eat for ourselves. You know, four slices per person." And I'm like, "I'm not really feeling too well, guys. Just come on, stop being a pussy." All right. So I walk over to this place, Joe's Pizzeria on the corner of Kearney Avenue and Belleville Turnpike.
Oh god, I'm gonna have to meet. So,
what was that?
Go on.
Anyway, go down over there and decide, hey, let's go get some pizza. And we get inside, and mind you, the entire time I'm sitting there, because jumping up and down in my seat. Because I can't contain how I'm about to shit myself. Now, the whole reason for this is because the night before, my mom decided to make chicken chili. And my mom's chicken chili is notorious, and I mean notorious, for causing you to want to shit the next day.
Want to or
so
need to?
So is every other food.
Yes. Anyway, I'm sitting there jumping up and down in my seat, trying to contain myself, and my friend Jason across from me is just like, dude, are you all right? And I'm like, I have to shit like a champion right now. And he just turns and he points out over the door down the hallway, and he's like, hey, just go over there, dude. The bathroom's right there. Just do your business. And I'm like, all right, fine. So I get inside, close the door behind me, lock it, and I look at the little stall, and... Mind you, it's not disgusting or anything. It's not bad. It's actually pretty pristine, enough to eat off of almost, though I wouldn't encourage it. My problem is, during that point, I was a little bitch, and I had an undying fear of public restrooms.
Oh, God.
I didn't know.
Did you crap all over yourself?
No, it's so good.
Just let me finish. Trust me. Don't question. Just let it go. So... I'm looking at it and I'm just like, I can't sit on that. I might get AIDS or something. So what does my smart 16-year-old self say? Let me get into a 3-point stance. And for those who don't know what a 3-point stance is, if you ever watched
Flam is gonna die. Flam is gonna die.
If you ever watched an American football game, the offensive line always gets in a 3-point stance in which they have two legs down and they're bent over and one arm is on the ground. So I get in this position over the toilet. Mind you, I played football. This is the whole reason that I was thinking this was a good idea. So I get over it, and I'm angling my ass, and I'm like, if a turd comes out this way, it'll plop right in, and we're done. Well, let me give you a little insight on this. It was not a turd. It was not a log. It was not anything heavy. It was actually rather light in the form of liquid.
Mist.
This is an understatement.
There was a splash zone.
The only point, after the point I decided to release the Kraken, all I heard behind me was. And it sounded like a tornado was going through.
Please tell me that was Flammenwerfer's little shriek.
Yes.
At this point. I'm appalled at my own self. I'm just staring at this door and I don't know what to do. And I, as soon as it's finally done, my asshole's burning, everything's ready to go, I'm ready to clean, get out of there. I stop for a moment, cold sweat starting to pale down my forehead, and I slowly start turning my head. And the entire time in my mind, I keep telling myself, don't look back, don't look back, don't look back. But I had to. There was no choice. My body was not going to allow me not to know what had happened. And as I turned my head over my shoulder, nothing but straight green goo layered from one wall, from my one side to the other, covering the toilet and everything along with it. At this point, I looked over at my mess and I just said to myself, oh my God. I had to hold back. I had fucking retch as I tried not to throw up in my over it. So I decided to wipe my ass and everything, throw it in the toilet. I was like, I may have fucked up, but at least I'm not going to leave that out. And I'm thinking to myself, someone has to clean this. But it sure as hell isn't going to be me. So I walk out, wash my hands, and I get back outside. I'm pale as fuck at this point, and I'm just sweating. I sit down, and I look at the other guys, and immediately Orlando and Nick, my two other friends who were with us, are just like, oh shit, something happened. I turn to Jason, and all he's got is a shit-eating grin on him.
Well, so he cleaned it?
No, wait.
His mouth?
Wait,
it gets better.
So he looks at me and he's just like, what did you do in there? And I'm like, there's nothing we need to worry about. We need to leave. He just starts giggling and runs past me into the bathroom. I'm trying to block him out, and he somehow dips past me and gets inside. So I sit down. I'm holding my hands between my head. Or my head between my hands. And I turn, my friend Nick and Orlando are just kind of like giggling, and they turn to me and they're like, dude, it can't be that bad. And I just turn to them, still pupils dilating, everything, and I'm just like, dude, you have no idea. 2 minutes later, Jason comes out of the bathroom, cold sweat, pale as fuck, sits down in front of me, and he's just like, dude, what happened in there?
Oh my god.
And I just lean over and I go, mom's chicken chili. He turns to the other two and just goes, we need to get out of here. Immediately, at this point, yeah. Something's wrong. And I know Jason, of all people, would like nothing more than me to be embarrassed and get fucked over by this. So I turn to him and I'm like, what did you do? He's like, I tried to clean it. What? You tried to clean my own shit? And he was like, sorta. What do you mean, sorta? He's like, well, I figured I'm in here. I gotta clean this up and I have to piss. You mean to tell me there's nothing but a pile of shit and piss on that floor? And he just kind of nonchalantly nods his head. And immediately we both turn to Orlando and Nick, who are now both pale from hearing it. And we're like, we have to go. We get up. We go up to the counter and we're like, can we get that pizza to go? We're going to miss class. Mind you, it's the middle of the summer. So the guy who's baking the pizzas just looks at me and he's just like, what? And I'm like, we need to go. Can we get those pizzas to go? So he's like, yeah, calm down. And he hands me the two pizzas. We pay him and we start getting out the door. I look around the corner. And all I see is some poor bastard with a mop and bucket head towards the toilet. I assume he was doing his routine cleanup. And at this point, I'm literally shoving everyone out the door with these pizzas in my hand. And I'm like, fucking go! Eventually, you get everyone out the door, and as I'm climbing down this little staircase, all I hear behind me as the door is closing is, what the fuck? We were gone.
But it doesn't end.
No.
Oh.
Let me fast forward 2 years ahead. I start going out with this Italian girl named Cassandra. And she's like, hey, I'm hungry. Let's go to my uncle's place and get something.
You're not serious.
And I'm like, sure. What is it? Is it like a fucking Spanish place or something? She's like, no, my uncle owns a pizzeria. And I'm like, sweet. Free pizza. We walk all the way to this pizzeria. And as soon as I see the front of it, and she's like, here we are. She starts climbing up the stairs and I won't move. And she turns to me and she's like, what's wrong? And I'm like, I don't want to eat her. Can we just go? And she's like, okay. So we went to her house and ordered the food.
Ta-da!
This is some shit straight out of 4chan. What the fuck?
Yes, yeah, straight out of 4chan.
Welcome to fucking folding pencil. What must I do in me?
By the way, I'm just going to say right now that stream folding brought in 6 new viewers.
Oh, God. Gets us to the next question.
Hold up. Someone wants me to tell a story that will abruptly stop. So anyway, I'm fucking this dude in the ass, right? And I'm balls deep.
Balls deep?
You reach around, right?
And did you have I Love You Philip Morris playing in the background?
Wait,
this guy reach around, and the fucker is hard.
What a fag.
Yeah. I bet he kisses girls, the faggot.
Oh. Anyway. Holding. Are wasps the worst creatures ever invented?
Fuck wasps. Fuck wasps. Fuck hornets. Fucking goddamn yellow jackets. Fuck anything that has a stinger, wings, and more than 4 legs. Because.
I have a buddy.
All right.
I'm fucking allergic to that shit.
So am I, and I have to work on fucking cable where you go to open the SDU on the side of someone's house, and those fuckers are hiding in there.
I like this one, what must I do, too? What must I do? Are wasps the worst creatures ever invented?
No, that would be hornets.
Ah, fair enough. What must I do? Has there ever been a time where writing has made you genuinely hate yourself?
Yes.
Is it is it something worth saying, or is it just any time you write?
Okay, you remember the story I wrote about Philomena?
Yes!
Oh, Christ.
Yeah.
You hated yourself?
Kinda.
I'm proud of you.
I don't understand.
Everyone else loved you for it, though.
It's okay.
Yeah, it was amazing.
Has there been a time where writing made you hate yourself?
There was a story called Barkeep.
That's great. Go read it, guys. Everyone read Barkeep. That's it. Don't. And end that.
I wrote it on a Stark Erection and a bottle of Jack. Don't touch that story.
But Bowling, just think, that's why you met me.
I still regret it.
I'm just trying to blow through my questions so we can get through other ones that actually matter. Bowling, how often do you remind yourself that this is all for a children's show?
It is?
Oh, God, it's when?
What must I do? How often?
Every time I look at my pistol and wonder just why...
Is today gonna be the day?
It's an opposite of when.
I just look at my gun and I'm just like, God, why not?
Stop.
Okay.
It's time to stop.
It's time to stop. It's time
I'm
to
just
stop,
trying to blow
the right
questions today. What must I do? Do people take themselves too seriously? If so, which is the answer is obviously yes, how do you best insult them to make them upset?
Definitely they do. And generally speaking, ignoring people that take themselves too seriously is a pretty good way to piss them off. Because they expect everyone else to take them seriously, too.
Treat them like they're the ghost from that Patrick Swayze movie.
I got a good one for this.
All right, Holden, what up?
Yes, people take themselves way too seriously in this shit. And the best insult is to look at them and tell them, who are you again?
Oh, that's a good one, actually.
And as soon as they say their name, you just tell them, never heard of you.
Yeah, that works.
Oh, that's so great. Good job.
I'd ask for your autograph, but I don't want it.
Good.
Holding.
What?
If you had to wear a bra from now on, what style, color, and type of bra would you mostly stick to?
I don't know anything about them other than...
The fireworks one.
What kind of color and lace?
Black and lacy soft.
All right, black lacy bras for Bolding. What must I do? What kind of bra would you wear?
Do tassels count?
Yes.
Definitely
pasties.
Those.
Pasties with little tassels on them? All right. I will keep that in mind.
Can I have a bra?
Okay. Bolding, would you suck a dick if that dick belonged to M.A. Larson and he was actually a corpse who would never be thanked again?
No. Because I can't thank him afterwards.
What must I do?
No, because it seems like sucking the dick of a corpse would be a waste of time.
Hey, they can still ejaculate after death, just so you know.
I know, but I mean, you know, he couldn't really be thankful for it. Come on. Well,
that's why they called him a stiff. Again.
It is his last thanking.
Right. Only if I can use rubber band on the bottom of it, then.
Yes, you can, and sexy losers, good job. So, what must I do? How drunk?
None, unfortunately. Well, I don't drink, so no.
Bolding, how drunk?
Yes.
Okay. Bolding, yes or no?
No.
What must I do? Yes or no?
Bitch, I might.
Oh. Was not ready.
Oh, shit. He got real in here.
He's out penciling the pencil.
All right. When's sculpting Woe Nelly love?
Fuck off.
Is that even English? Yeah, it's not. Next, okay. Priest, would you like to take over for the rest of these questions? I blew through mine really quick, so.
I would be happy to.
Please do.
Who did we leave off with? What must I do first last time?
It doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
They both answer it, and what must I do will totally answer them.
All right. Question number one from this new set of questions. After willpower and blood, what is the best lubricant? What must I do?
Clown paint.
What? I was gonna say bacon,
I'm gonna have to put this up like permanently after.
That's gonna be on the t-shirt.
Best cast we've ever had. Woo. Okay, I'm done.
What
okay.
is the best like... lubricant?
I was gonna go with bacon grease, but I can't beat that, so.
Clown paint.
I concede defeat. So.
I think he's been looking at these for a few days. He's like writing down everything he wants to say.
Oh, well, this God. One, I've looked at the first few, but I haven't gotten down this far yet.
All right.
I think these are new.
Next one. How many of you have fapped to Rainbow Factory? Bolding,
have
you?
Never read it.
Just say I if you have. What must I do? That simple.
Nope.
Who said yes?
I didn't say yes. I said I.
Did you fap to it?
Oh, it was on in the background.
It counts.
Those dramatic readings are full of emotion. I like emotion.
All right, next question.
All right, next question. What must I do? How do you explain Fulcon to Scootaloo without using your penis?
Oh, borrowing one of Pencil's horsed cocks, yeah.
I love you. Anyway, thank you.
Folding.
No. Penis is not for Philly.
Casual are you?
Right. I was just mentioning.
It doesn't matter much to my penis, but I totally use my vagina, so there you go.
That doesn't count. Panel. It's not Fulcon.
Bolding.
If I stick her hooves in it, it is. Anyway.
Bolding, how much vomit is a turnoff?
I don't want to get into this, so I'm skipping.
What must I do? How much vomit is a turnoff?
We'd be here too long.
That depends on why she's vomiting. If it's because my dick is down her throat, then there's never enough.
I never said
if it's
she.
For another reason... Oh, well, that's weird. If it's because his and or her...
Good.
Z.
Yeah. There you go. If it's because my dick is down their throat, I will never be turned off. Otherwise, any...
Yes, my answer to the last question was obviously vomit. So anyway,
if vomit shoots up the hole, I'm gonna run.
Which is more offensive, neckbeards or Nazis?
Well, I know what must I do is answer to this.
Neckbeards.
Yep.
Bolding.
Yep.
Neither. Both were pussies.
All right. Good.
Topical.
All right. Next question. What do you like about the new characters we've had on the show recently, other than how glorious they are to fap to? Bolding.
Wait, people still watch the show?
Right.
Oh my god, you guys.
Same here.
I
haven't
solid
watched
answer.
It, so I wouldn't know.
They're both a fan of the fandom, guys. It's okay.
No, we stopped after season two when it stopped being a kid show.
That's not true, Bolding. You watched Pinkie Pride with me.
That was with you, and that was it.
And you loved it.
It doesn't count if it's with a woman.
Right?
Friggin' Otaku's been strutting around like he owns the place because he got top of the featured list for writing porn about the new character.
Oh god,
yeah.
We're playing with
like fucking everyone. God, I'm so done with Ember. So fucking done with Ember.
Oh, I've been around for like 2 weeks.
She was nice to Spike. I've been done with her ever since. Next question.
Which is hotter, Pinkie Pie filleting you with an open wound,
filleting,
or Twilight crushing your testes with a rock? Bolding.
Where's the wound that I'm being filleted with?
Lower back.
It?
Lower back.
Huh? Yes.
Okay. What must I do?
Probably the pinky one, since Twilight's a fucking whore.
Alright, right. There you go.
What is your weapon of choice for dispensing a
I know.
Strike? What must I do?
My dick.
Bolding.
That was gonna be my answer.
He beat me to it, so I'm gonna say, my ass.
My sheer force of will.
His snoring.
Oh, yeah. Bolding would just, like, sound bomb
his fuck off, man.
His nighttime snuggles.
Question number 9, and I'm going to plead the 5th on this one. Have you ever looked at your collection of plushies and thought, you're all the women I need?
No.
No, you have.
No.
But, Bolding, you have a pretty plush. I know you do.
I have two, and they sit in my living room.
You have one
you just...
on the way.
Can you just like
actually
a
already
pink
got
one,
it.
Like pink version of Old Nelly?
Yeah, I got it today when I came home from work.
Is it a pretty pony?
It's a little crying Colgate. So,
wait, priest, you need to get a pink version of Whoa Nelly, and that can be your new waifu.
No, stop.
Oh God, what must I do? Have you ever looked at your plushie collection for any reason?
I don't have any, so
that's
no.
What I figured. He's what must I do is actually like.
He's got the body pillow, though.
He's a
nightmare!
The hell?
Yes, 8th also says, don't forget, Bolding, you also have a body pillow.
Stop.
Hammer time.
This question, I never asked for this. Why is Perry Heartbreak so undeniably handsome?
I'm going to give the same answer I do every single time, and that answer is denial.
I am so awesome.
No, no, the answer is denial and probably hallucinogenic mushrooms, because there's no other way anyone could ever
find him. Look at my chin. I have the squarest chin you've ever seen. I am Bruce Campbell.
You are not. How dare you use that man's
name?
I am
Bruce
Campbell.
You're
not worthy of Bruce Campbell's name. Fuck you and fuck you for eternity. You are never allowed to speak his name. Fuck you for even implying.
Campbell's chicken noodle soup.
All right, the next question. How edgy are you?
Mark Shelley.
You sound like a pretty big faggot, so very.
Yes.
Bolding.
I didn't write Diaries of Mad Man, so no.
Fucking got him!
Got him!
Edgier than Mark Shelley.
I'm going to ask this next set of questions.
I'll flame you!
Oh, it's flame. Okay.
Yes.
Bolding, why is Flamin Warford's helmet so shiny?
Literally, who?
What must I do? Why is Flamin' Warfare's helmet so shiny?
No idea who that is, but probably because it's covered in cum.
All right, next question.
It's not shiny.
Something that's happened to you, either good that you're willing to share, bad, inspired you to write a story. What must I do?
All right, so I wrote a story a while back called Taxidermist Anon. And in that, well, basically, Anon taxidermies some animals, some Fluttershy's animals. And I wrote that one because my stepmother is a taxidermist, and she was talking about doing that to a pet.
Jesus.
So, yeah.
Oh, God.
You need to link that so we can read it.
Okay.
All right.
All right. Golden can.
All right, I'm back. I had to take a fucking call, sorry. And I heard someone say my helmet was covered in cum, so thank you for that.
Where do I start with this?
But it's the best cum, it's Stella cum.
We are now crunched for time, so if you've got something small that's awesome, please say so.
Let's see, the stories that have been based on are Cabin Fever, Cabin Fever, I don't know my stories. It's been so long since
I've What about Unlikely Hunter, Baldin?
Shut up!
But Unlikely Hunter is great,
Cabin Fever.
I love it.
Shut up!
Sprinkle.
Cabin Favor. This stinks.
Words?
What?
You sound like you're trying to make words there.
No, the two stories. It's actually only two stories. So it was Cabin Favor and This Stinks are based on true stories.
Hmm. So, all right. Yeah. You have to do that.
Who is more annoying? And I want to ask this question. Who is more annoying, Sunset, Shimmer, or Ember? Bolding.
Both.
The same person.
All right. And what must I do?
Never seen either of them in the show, so no clue.
Well, they're both annoying. I'll put it that way. Ah, what must I do? Meme fix, good or bad?
So bad that they become good.
Yes, agreed. Bolding.
Depends. If they're quality, I'll work with it.
What kind of quality?
Quality.
There you go.
American
wow.
Made.
You can continue. You can continue, Priest.
All right. Klopp writers. What's the hardest part about writing Klopp? And if you say my dick, I swear I'm a mum. Bolding.
It's not hard. It's literally write down shit that happens during sex and get easy views because you're a fuckboy.
Jesus.
Yeah, we never actually mentioned the quality of writing it. It could be a terrible one.
I will say, the hardest part about writing Klopp is not my dick, it's your dick. Anyway, what must I do?
Hardest part is making it not just penis and vagoo. You gotta
make it
actually interesting.
Yeah.
Penis I would agree with
difficult
that.
To do
a lot of them get really repetitive really fast.
Yeah, I mean, if you, like, read some of the popular writers, basically they just copy and paste all of their stories and add different names.
Otaku!
Not naming any names.
Otaku!
Alright. The next question is directed precisely to what must I do. How the fuck is Diaries of a Madman still going? Like, holy shit, how do you even keep a fist passed without word count still going? Like, seriously, what the fuck?
The reason I don't seem completely 100% autistic is because I put all of it in words, and that's why it's still going.
That's a fair answer, actually.
Is it gonna die then when you die?
One of these days.
No, it will live on after his death. We will continue to write it in fan fiction form. There's nothing you can do about it.
So what you're saying is the story is literally autism.
It's written autism.
It is. It is actual autism.
I made Otaku salty.
All right. Next question. Imagine you're a presidential candidate for a leader of fan fiction. How will you make the Future Fox great again?
Well, I know. What must I do? The answer. Like a candidate. No.
Build a firewall.
Let's go to holding.
No. What must I do? I love the answer. It's about to happen. Oh no! What must I do first, please?
Okay. What must I do? All right.
Let Nev go first. Go ahead.
I don't really know what you're expecting. Basically, just ban Klopp.
Well, fuck you.
I think the only language on the site is English.
Ready for the what?
I was ready for the racism, man.
Only Earth phonies there, happy?
Yes, thank you.
Nice. Bolding, how would you fix the feature box?
Now, I have to say a lot of people have been asking me this question. No, really. A lot of people have been coming to me and they say, how can we make the feature box great again? And I tell them, look, we know what the feature box being great again is. We've had almost 8 years of the worst kind of freaking stories that you can imagine. Oh my God, I can't believe it. Addition, subtraction of the whole stories being good and bad. It's terrible. It's just terrible. Look, if you want to know what will make the feature box great again, do you want to know what the feature box is?
I'll tell you.
The feature box is a shit stone. It's nothing. Nothing good in it. And what we need to do is we need to build a wall around it.
Yes.
We need to build a wall around it. Around the entire feature box.
I can't.
And only then can we save Fan Fiction.
Oh my God.
That sounds about right.
It is a tragedy against the site. It is a tragedy that the top 1% of fimfictioners have 90% of the followers.
I think Bolding wins. I think just Bolding wins everything.
We need to raise taxes, and what must I do? He has too much words. We need to take some of those words, give them to the poor.
Okay, let's next question, please.
Holes. Oh, God.
We're actually doing
really well on time.
Yeah, I rushed us through my questions.
We have
no worries.
5 minutes left and 15 questions. So if anyone has questions...
I have a special guest that wants to say hello to Bolding when we're done, so...
Oh, okay.
I know who it is.
What must I do? Are you talking to people in Twitch chat? Because they want to say hi.
I'm not in the Twitch chat.
All right, let me read you some of the things they've said. Hold on. These are what your lovely fans want to say to you.
Oh, God.
I love Diaries of a Madman. I read it when I was sick for a month.
I got through the first chapter. Killing
myself. Hold on. What else we got? Diaries of Madman has the driest character of all time. It is weaponized autism. Nuke that.
Yeah, sounds about right.
All featured writers are rapists.
Me too.
Everyone in Twitch chat, you should give your opinions on his story. So
you carry the burden of the worst story on the site.
No, there I carry, because I'm the
That's
carrier.
All the same person. What are you talking about?
No, that was actually several different people.
Is really tame today.
Yeah, they're being really nice. Next question, please.
Next question. At what point does a parody satire fic cross over into disparaging territory? Bolding.
No.
Yes, good.
Got some more people's opinions.
Onions. More onions.
More layers.
More layers.
What must I do answer this, and then we can go back to the comments.
I will gladly read them again.
Never.
At what point does parody satire fit cross over into disparaging territory?
Never.
I would also agree with this.
I mean, it's parody and satire. It can't
be
disparaging.
It's disparaging.
It can't be over the top.
Yeah.
Is that disparaging?
So, what must I do? I have never read Diaries of a Madman. Diaries are for faggots. What is Diaries of a Madman? I like it, but hated the early chapters. Keep writing that shit.
I rewrote the early chapters so they're not as shit anymore, at least.
Hey, hear that? It's actual input from the author. He says he rewrote the early chapters, so you can go back and reread them now.
If you know, you can handle that. It's a lot to reread.
Diaries of a Madman is a story about a a fag named Navarone who's super special and is super best friends with the people. Diaries is the story where the human is disgusted with having sex with a pony and goes and screws a naga. That is all I remember.
Atlas.
All right, on to the question.
Next question.
And then she gets killed.
Number 9. By the same motion, what's your opinion on fics specifically meant to parody and or invoke offense on controversial topics? What must I
yes.
do? Office Love Win.
Whatever. If they want to write, they want to write. I don't really care.
I think they're great. So, there you go.
Folding.
If you feel the need to write something based on something that's popular at the moment, I think you need to rethink why you're writing.
Otaku! Yeah.
What if we're writing it to fuck with somebody who's already written something that we know? Like,
If that's the case, that is not something that's popular at the time. That's just you trying to be a faggot. Oh,
but so. You can do both. But, anyway.
Is this about my waifu?
Yes. Caden's a shit. Die in a fire. Anyway,
your waifu's shit.
All right. Next question.
Clean your pillow.
Is there a way, I'm assuming on fanfiction, to tell an author's ability by merit of follower count? Upvote, downvote, or can you only determine by reading them for yourself? Bolding.
I'm gonna wait for this.
I'm gonna tell you right now, I don't have many followers, but...
You have 440 or so, dude.
I don't consider that many. You know how much, how many 400 people could be? That's an elementary school, so get out.
Yeah, a whole elementary school likes you.
Ew.
You are the
that,
best.
That sounds
you are the,
on par with getting
you
sexual offenders. Anyway, upvote downvote ratio doesn't mean shit because I'm pretty sure imaginary friend is still like 23rd or some shit, and the ratio wise, and it's a horrible fucking story. So the only way to determine it is by reading the stories yourselves and stop being a pussy and looking at numbers in hope of finding a good story.
Clap, yep. clap. I like
unless
that.
It's like 60 downvotes, one upvote.
And then
yeah,
it
gets to a point.
Then
where
it's a great
like...
story. You need to read that.
But guys, what about number of words?
So what
yeah.
can I do? What's
like,
that?
What must I do then?
Followers don't mean shit. Upvote, downvote don't mean shit. Really, the only way to tell is by reading it yourself.
Mm-hmm. But what if we don't have the time in our lives?
Then you need to reevaluate your priorities. Pwn always comes first.
Otaku!
Anyway, I have to say, the only thing that follower count probably does is that someone knows how to social network pretty well, and somebody knows how to write to their audience pretty well. Other than that,
yeah.
Nope! Next question.
Alright, next question. Number 11. Is an author's ability to write purely subjective, or is some objective consensus beyond basic spelling and grammar and sentence structure? Can you measure a writer's skill? Is I think the question at the end of the day.
Essentially, I feel that is a loaded question because we need to make fanfic great again. No, but I really think that's a loaded question. And that just because someone can't write well doesn't mean that they can portray a good story. I mean, I can tell a good story if I'm in person with someone or talking.
Or
but
I'm here.
When it comes to writing, it's fucking garbage.
I disagree with that wholeheartedly, Balding.
I don't.
Well, there is one example that I will bring up just as a... My favorite story, the whole thing that got me into HIE, was Lyra's Confession, and it's written like shit, but it's a good story.
I have... Okay, so, can I weigh in on this, please? Can I have a moment?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, so, I've had to edit for a lot of people. That's part of my career. I've had to edit for a lot of people. And I will put this out there. Beyond grammar, beyond just sentence structure, there are bad writers. What makes them bad is their ineffectiveness. If you're trying to get a point across, if you're trying to say something to a specific audience, think of it if you're trying to write anything that's advertising writing. If it's not effective and it doesn't reach your audience, it is ineffective, and that goes for fiction as well. And if your story is not getting said what you want to said, if your story is not reaching the people you want it to reach, and if it's not doing a good job of portraying what you want it to portray, then congratulations, you're not a good writer. You can get to be a good writer. You can practice. You can work on it. Everyone starts this shit. Everyone writes a lot of shit before they're good. But anyone who says there's no such thing as bad writers needs to suck a dick, because I've edited for bad writers. And there is nothing worse than sitting down and realizing that somebody doesn't know how to write a goddamn essay, paragraph, sentence, fuck. Yeah.
I kind of echo everything that Pencil said. I'll try and put it down in a little smaller package. There's a lot of bad writers, and no matter what you do, no matter how hard you work at it, there's someone that's going to be better than you. But it doesn't mean that you shouldn't try to become better than them.
But there are bad writers. There are bad writers.
But if you're doing it for fun, don't force yourself to do it to the point where you start to hate it.
Yeah.
Okay, now that I've ranted, I'm really sorry. Sorry. What must I do? It is up to you.
It is not purely subjective. You can be really good at grammar and all that shit, and sentence structure and whatever, and still be a bad writer. And you can be really bad about all that shit and be a not terrible writer, but still pretty bad. I mean, Tolkien was really good with all of that shit, but his stories were absolutely terrible.
I agree with that. Yeah.
I agree.
Tried reading Lord of the Rings. Jesus, that book is awful.
One of my favorite books? That's okay. That's fine.
Doesn't it go like fucking mental with the imagery? Like,
Oh, fuck off.
Okay.
See, I don't understand where you're coming from, because I listened to the whole series book on tape, because, you know, it was easier for me to listen to that and draw at the same time than it was for me to try and read and draw at the same time.
So it's background noise.
So
that being said, we should definitely not argue about Tolkien. It is the worst thing to argue about besides Ayn Rand.
He's salted the nuts.
No, it's not an argument. I'm curious. How do you think it's a bad story?
It's the writing style is just absolutely dry. I like the story, but I hate the writing.
Come at me, bro.
The writing style is way too dry.
If you're talking about the writing style, you have to remember the era that it was written in. So no. I've tried to read things from the 30s and 40s, and it's difficult to read that stuff and understand it, but I understood it.
1890 dry.
Okay. What is?
Oh God! We already answered this question, but let's ask what must I do. Let's ask what must I do first, please.
The funniest place you've ever taken a shit.
I have no good stories for that. Sorry.
My pants.
All right. Let's go to the real winner. This question is the one that I've been waiting for all day. Can fedoras ever be cool again? What must
only
I do?
Only if they have buttons.
Only
in
if covered in Kanan's buttons. Only if covered in Kanan's buttons.
Fedoras aren't
okay.
Cool.
Turn your camera on again, Flutter.
Trilbies are disgusting. Real fedoras, legit fedoras, like Humphrey Bogart fedoras, are great. And if you wear them and you're not Humphrey Bogart, you can suck a dick. I'm done.
Hey, dude, priest, you have to turn your camera on.
Show the fedora?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm going to do it again? Here we go.
Surprisingly, my internet has not been shitty. I might actually be able to see it this time.
Priest, we can't. Our viewers cannot see it because you are hosting.
Yes, I can. Hold on. I got this.
I see his icon at the top, but I don't know what's going on.
But that's part of the Twitch thing.
Oh, it's behind. It's behind.
Yeah, dude, it's behind the Twitch thing.
You guys need to give it a second to update.
Never.
Like,
never.
Holy, hold on. Okay.
You're showing us your face. Realize that.
I know. Really? People have
you
seen
can
my
move,
face
you can,
many
you
times.
You should be able to move
okay,
that.
Okay, I'm just waiting for Twitch chat to like freak out when they see that.
And I
there they go. There they go.
Wow, Priest looks really Jewish.
He's a Jewish transgender.
He's trans-Jewish, thank
oh,
you very
Snuffy.
Much.
Snuffy's got good opinions.
Oh, fuck you.
Those are buttons.
Next question, please. Let's please go to the next question.
All right. Let's get this ugly mug of me off the stream.
Yeah, I'm going to have to burn my computer now. Thanks.
What notable stories have inspired a story that you have written or writing in general?
I'm going to drop the word notable from my question. So what stories have inspired a story that you've written or your general writing?
Holden.
None of the above.
You've never been inspired.
Not by any stories, no.
Okay.
I was inspired by a movie.
Sure.
Because mine's kind of based off the Truman Show.
The movie's technically a story.
What must I do?
Too many to count.
Aw, is there any one particular piece of writing that's ever inspired you guys? Like, really inspired you guys?
I have... Probably, but I don't remember any in particular.
Not Tolkien, obviously.
Any clown literature?
Oh, Jesus.
I have one movie that definitely inspired a story of mine.
Lion King.
It's fucking... The story's trash, but Memento inspired me to write some stuff.
If we're talking about film fiction, fucking nothing.
Doesn't matter.
But...
I still say The Truman Show.
I've always wanted to write after reading things like Handmaid's Tale. Dystopian futures, just in general. Always make me want to write things, because they make me angry. So, yeah, there you go.
Have you seen Deus Ex?
Talking books, guys. Talking the books game? Right now. Come on.
I actually did just write a small little series thing in my book, or my story, rather, called based on Heart of Darkness.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Cool.
The horror.
Sweet.
Heart of Darkness is good shit, guys.
At least it's based off the Flower Trio.
Fuck off. No. I've no shits left to give for you today.
Dang it!
Alright, the next question. What notable stories have been...
Nope.
Fuck, we did that one.
Good job.
Would you curb stomp a kitten for $15 billion?
Dude, I'd do it for fucking 20...
You wouldn't have to pay me. Just give me a kitten. Come on.
Bruh.
We get all drawn together movie up in here.
Yeah, you just gotta give me $20 and I'm good to go.
Alright, we've entered our last few questions here. We got 7 left.
Yay!
Question number 1. Is Spike dead in all stories he isn't directly mentioned?
Yes!
What must I do?
Probably not.
Bolding.
Yes.
He's just irrelevant.
Pencil.
Yes, he's dead at all times. All times. Even when you see him, no. He's already dead.
He's a zombie.
Dead.
All right.
No, he's not even a zombie.
Question.
He doesn't exist.
It's a follow-up
sorry,
question. Should he be? Folding.
I'm sorry, I'm having a dispute over the writer's chat. What happened?
Should he be dead?
Who?
Should Spike be dead in stories that he isn't in?
Oh, yes.
Spike should just be dead.
What must I do?
What must I do?
Probably not.
Aww. Okay.
You lost pencil points.
See, if I was an admin in chat, this is where we'd boot. What must I do?
But... What must I do does not give two shits about what I think, and that's why I think he's great.
I'm sorry, is someone talking?
Yeah, exactly.
Pencil more cannibalism win.
Oh, actually. Soon. I did just post something
that
involved...
Can you send me a link to whenever you're done? Because I'm probably going to be into that.
Oh, God.
Next question.
Yes?
Oh, so... Hold on, I need to say something, because I need you guys to hear that this is a thing. So, apparently, and I know he doesn't care, because he's said as much. People ask me all the time if I'm into the shit I write about. I finally found somebody who's, like, into literally all the shit I write about.
Oh, God.
And it's Regidar.
Oh, yes.
Oh, my God.
You know, I'm not fucking surprised.
He's in everything. Like, I get messages like, dude, that was hot. I'm like, that was about skull fucking. So...
Regidar is an interesting creature.
He's a nice creature. He has stopped taking himself so seriously, and I told him he took himself too seriously, and he listened.
He hung
so,
with all of us at BabsCon. It was a really good time.
I just wanted to let you know that I'm done now. I'll stop.
I'm glad you didn't spend the night with him.
God, no.
The next question.
Silence.
Awkward silence. The next question is, why is Princess Celestia best princess? Bolding.
Answer is she's not.
She's bland.
What was the question?
Praise the sun. Is sun butt best sun butt?
Yes.
Silence. Stop.
What must I do?
Yes, because that ass.
That ass.
Does anyone weigh in on why sun butt is best princess?
It's an odd way to say moon butt. What accent is that?
Jewish.
Oh, God.
Jesus.
He didn't say shekels once.
Alright.
Alright.
Next question is, we'll start with Boulding. When will Diaries of a Madman end?
Why the fuck are you asking me?
Right. When What Must I Do Is Dead. So next week.
It'll end when he's dead, let's be honest. What Must I Do? When will Diaries end?
Whenever I wake up, but I can't wake up, so...
Wake me up before you go.
No. Will someone wake you up inside?
Yeah.
Save me from myself. Like
yo-yo.
Thank you.
The next question, What Must I Do, will go to you. When will Imaginary Friend end?
When I give it permission to.
Shit!
Boulding.
Maybe.
Yes.
All right. Boulding, next question. When will Office Love end?
Already Office has. Love when?
That voice.
What Must I Do? When will Office Love end?
Never heard of it. Sounds like shit.
Good.
that sense of fucking...
It already has. Let's all be honest. He's never going to finish it.
It's over. It's all over. Right.
This question comes from our Twitch watchers, which we've now ran out of questions. So if anyone in the chat wants to provide additional questions for our guests...
No questions too stupid.
You can ask for stories. We will add them to the list. So the first question that we have is, what band, named after a location, like a city, state, park, etc., is the best? Boulding.
Boulding's not listening. Boulding's in the middle of a flame war. Ask him what I do.
Anyway,
Chicago a band?
Yes.
Is mayonnaise an instrument?
I got nothing. I don't know any bands named after...
I think someone's fishing for a Boston comment.
Yes.
Kansas.
Kansas!
Fucking Kansas. Fuck Kansas.
I'm gonna take that answer.
Princess Kansas.
What must I do? What is your answer?
The only one that I know of offhand is Alabama, but their music probably sucks, since everything from Alabama sucks.
The questions...
Florida!
The answers to the next questions are both no.
Do we just
mine's not involved in that.
Do
that's
you
the.
Just skip past those two?
That's fine. But actually, I'm going to bring in a special guest for Boulding to say hello to. I will be right back.
We have a special guest. Okay.
She tied someone up in her basement. Watch out.
Shit. Oh, you mean there's somebody else besides Priest in her house?
It's the guy that tried cleaning up his little accident.
Mm. So, if there's no closet space, where does he stay?
It's all of them,
under the bed.
Mm. Right. You can put these on and talk.
Oh, guys,
I know who it is already. I know who it is already.
And you are on the HIE group. And that includes.
Hi, Boulding.
Hi, Skittle Tits.
How goes it?
Hey, Skittle Tits.
I'm living the dream as usual.
Oh, cool.
I hear Priest.
Sounds like Priest. You're talking now in front of 22 people. Say hi.
Hi, everyone. There are 22 of you.
22 people, including some of us.
Is, but cool.
Well, you still get highs anyway.
Tell them you wrote a story about shining armor.
We can hear you.
Yeah, they can hear you still.
I know. Just tell them that in general.
Hey, Priest, do you remember the story I wrote with shining armor?
It's time to stop.
It's time to stop.
Time to stop. No, it's not time to stop.
No.
Yes.
Okay, I got a quick question. Hi. Question. Hello. Who are you?
It's Flamin' Warfer.
What the fuck are you talking about?
It's Wawa Skittle.
That's my alter personality. Fucking...
Nobody knows who it is, so it's Flamin' Warfer.
Yeah, very good. Very good.
Oh,
and they're
going to
break. But seriously, who are you?
It's Skittle Tits. What do you mean, who is it?
Yeah, how do you not know who Wawa Skittle Tits is? Jesus.
Do you think I go outside or socialize?
No, you don't need to.
Not really. I'm really not.
Where are they?
So, one of the questions
in the
chat
right
now...
We will link it, I promise. Everybody wants to see it. I will link it.
Yeah,
Priest, everyone wants to see my story.
It's online.
I'll get a link to it.
Everyone, you have to go favorite it and then downvote.
It's called All's Well, isn't it?
I don't remember. Pencil, what'd you name it?
Who is all and why is he swelling?
The one that's up.
Shut the fuck.
Oh god, fuck, what did I call that?
Oh, I remember. I made a special spot in my library.
It's like my most downvotes I've ever seen on one of my stories, which isn't even mine, which makes it even better.
I know what I called it, but that's different than
what the fuck? What happened?
Bowling, you douchebag.
Why did I get kicked? What happened?
He forgot he was host.
Good. That's what? Great.
On the cover of the Molding Stone.
Did you really just...
Wow.
Fuck, guys. Like, that was awful.
Still less, not as awful as the...
Molding just peeped out.
Yeah.
God, really? Well, I guess that's the end of our stream.
Such is life.
I mean, we'll still take some more questions.
We still have one special guest.
Enigmatic Otaku's questions. What's the story? Where we're talking about? It's in the chat now.
Oh god, hi Kat. No, it's okay. She can say hello. Just everyone say bye to Skittle Tits. Bye guys.
Bye guys. Skittle Tits.
Pepperonis.
Bye.
They all say bye. Story. She can go with you. If anyone cries, I'll let you know.
Okay.
There's still two more questions, which we can still take. What must I do? Will you ever do a Cuck Spike story?
I could. I've been thinking about it just to fuck with him.
Do it.
Is anyone
I like seeing emotional
suffering.
I like emotional torment.
Alright, I'm ready for the next question.
The next question is, when will someone utterly annihilate Enigma's ego? And
okay, here we go.
Oh, go for it.
I don't know who that is.
Hold on, we got this. Enigma, I would like to tell you a few things about yourself. First of all, you are shit. You are literal shit. I don't mean that you know your stories are shit and you're a shitty person. I mean, when you wake up in the morning, I wonder how much of a stain you leave on the mattress. Does it smell when you get home? How long has it been gestating there? How much residue do you leave with every step you take?
He's
when
you
speak to people, smell the stench? Do you realize how whenever you say a word or write anything down, people can feel the fumes of your refuse wafting off of it?
I've got no idea what's going
on. And you feel like you're proud of your existence? No. Your existence is that you are the refuse of people who have come before you who are much greater than yourself. You should realize you are shit. Accept it. Roll in it. And die in the stinky heap that you are. I'm done.
I have something to say too.
What the fuck?
Otaku, if you were in a movie, they'd call it Kung Fu Pander. Because your stories are pander.
I literally.
All right. Oh, fucking poor fucking Bolding. Bolding just is like, no, I'm done. He's not coming back.
He's like priest when
he's
having technical difficulties.
What happened to Bolding?
He had to do something.
Where is Bolding? 2012.
Otaku is putting dots in the chat. Oh, I think we just made him kill himself. Otaku, I love you.
We have one last question.
I don't think Enigma's actually hurt by what I say. He should know by now that if he gives a shit about what I have to say, then he's made some bad decisions in his life.
Otaku, you senpai.
Alright, cool. Another question.
We have one last question from some dork. Mother's Day is coming up. How will Cadence be celebrating it?
What must in the garbage, do? Like she should be.
Blending up
bad
the little...
ponies don't get celebrated.
Thank you.
Blending up McDiabetes.
Getting D.
Probably weeping over the corpse of her infant.
She's getting D.
I don't think that's considered an infant. I think that's a mutant.
Didn't you know?
Pretty sure it's a guard.
The baby.
The baby.
Don't touch the child.
Episode.
The baby. At the end, mom going, are we just going to call it the baby? It's like they did. All episode. Jesus Christ.
I like that even Cadence felt absolutely no urgency in fucking naming her own spawn.
The baby.
That's because she doesn't matter. She knows her opinion is shit. So whatever she would name it would just be shit and bland.
All the other ones died
for
that.
Not even Shining.
Thing.
Shiny's too tired attached. Of everyone's shit.
He's like literally retarded, so.
Yeah, I'm retarded.
Pretty sure you
well,
get
he's
an albino.
A nerdy jock. I mean, really.
Yeah, he's gonna leave her anyway.
Do we have any other questions?
We'll take anything else in the chat. Otherwise, we can probably, I mean.
Oh, I said I would post Skittletit's story.
I put it in the chat.
It's already in the Twitch.
Oh shit! Sorry. It says deleted link. Yeah. Anyway, that's fine.
Yeah, my chat auto deletes links. So, alrighty then.
Any final questions? Seriously, guys.
What are we doing with our lives?
Well, let me ask you guys a question. Do you think this cast should be put on YouTube?
Yeah.
Sure, why not?
I'd probably export this and then put it on my YouTube so that way people can watch it later.
Yeah, link everyone.
Why not YOLO?
Two reasons. Number one, Bolding stories are immaculate. Number two, clown paint.
Right. Yeah. If you're going to post anything on YouTube, it should be this one.
Clown paint.
Do we want to make that a habit and just do that all the time, or
sure. In the description, I'd say load up I'd say post a bunch of links. You know where the Twitch stream is and everyone who is involved, their profile and their stuff.
All right.
So, yeah, do that.
Because I totally
want to take back what Pencil said here. And no, not immaculate.
Oh, hey, Bolding, you're back. Hi, baby.
Boldo, plus.
I'm sorry, I'm having a flame war right now.
Hey, I understand, but that's why I'm not crossing too much.
So, here's
the thing. You do what you gotta do, Bolding. You do.
Oh, it's taken care of. But anyway.
It is done. Slaughter was
Never Have I Ever. We need to play Never Have I Ever. Bolding.
I'd say we would, but we are all in a time crunch here, me included. I have some family matters I need to actually look after.
I've been dying to make these burgers for the past, 3 hours.
So, let's adjourn, but I will say.
I'm an Asian kid.
To the many people in our chat, for change. Hell yeah, many people in our chat. Thank you for coming. Thank you for listening to us. You got to hear What Must I Do, who is known for Diaries of a Madman and for being great, and for trying to make the future box great again.
No more shredded cheese.
And for clown paint. He's been here. You can say goodbye or tell us to fuck ourselves or something.
Literally who...
Okay, and thank you. Ooh, and Bolding, who, as you now know, shits on walls and drops spaghetti.
Stop.
And has to eat it.
He's the literal embodiment of 4chan.
And then there's the rest of us, Flame Warfer, who squeals like a rodent when he's laughing.
That was laughing particularly hard. Fuck off.
Carrier, who will never be as handsome as he wants to be. Rab, who had to put up with some serious snoring, and Milk, who faps his cat.
I take offense to that.
Totally.
And I'm Pencil, I'm the one with the vagina. So, oh, and of course, and Priest.
Besides for Rav.
Who Hi. Hosted when shit went down. Thank you for hosting when shit went down, dude.
Thanks for everyone who stayed to watch in the Twitch chat.
Thanks for sticking around.
It took like half an hour.
I did have fun. This was good. And we hope you'll join us next time when we have, I don't know who. I don't fucking know who's here next time.
Do we have next week scheduled?
Who do we have?
If not,
week?
I can find some people who I specifically want to be on this, and it will happen.
I have Drop Bear for next week, but I have to.
Oh, God.
Okay, you guys still need to explain to me what the problem is with that with him.
No, we'll talk later, baby.
You have it. Okay, suspicions folder. You don't know.
No, that's a fucking enough.
Someone sent me a list of displaced writers, but I didn't look at it.
It's time to go.
Did you displace the list?
Shut up!
So we're all shit. You've been here with us, being shit with us. Thanks to our guests. Honestly, thank you both for coming on. I know that neither of you wanted to do this, because we're shit. Bye.
Alright.
See you around. Bye.
Right. Wanted to do it.
Bye.
No, bye-bye. Seriously, thanks for coming on, both of you. Sorry we're so shitty. Hope you guys had a good time, or at least got to
this week get wasn't as... Us.
Me too, thanks.
Find out next week's guest. Next time,
Dragon Ball Z.
Same bat time, same bat channel. Anyway, have a good evening, guys. Take care and die in a fire. Bye.
Thank you. This was the shittiest outro ever. Have a good day.